All right, let's see. Okay, right now the results are 7 votes to try the Diablo's door, 2 to investigate the window, and none to go back through the door. Anyone else? Anyone else interested? If you guys want to get involved, please do so. Please do so if you guys want to get involved in this process. What's it gonna be? What's it gonna be? Last call, last call. Oh, thanks, Net. I would hope that would be unanimous, but who knows? Thanks, dude. I appreciate it. Hey, Thorg, what's up, man? I was wondering where you were, Thorg. I figured you were a big part of the this process. Thorg, you can be part of our brand new. It's not actually brand new, but it's brand new that I'm using it a lot. The new pulse system that was set up by Law with some actually by Shadowed and Law together. Kind of they sort of adjusted each other's bots, which sounds vaguely inappropriate, but how you doing, Ned? How you doing, Thorg? All right, make your decision, guys. Last call, last call. Oh, sick as a dog. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Thorg. That sucks, man. Well, you can try to get well with us, right? Okay, everyone wants to go through the Diablo's door. Sounds good. I guess we'll find out. You step into the room and close the door behind you. The room is empty and you heave a sigh of relief, falling back against the door to catch your breath. Will you rest in the room or try the window for a means of escape? Okay, is it going to be rest in the room or try the window? What's it going to be, guys? Rest in the room or try the window? Go ahead and make your vote. Tough call. This one's a tough call, actually. Because we could definitely use the stamina. I mean, our stamina is not great. But I also don't know if, you know, it's the House of Hell. So, who knows? Seems like rest seems appropriate. Yeah, what could possibly go wrong, right? Because there are no provisions or anything like that, so this is basically you're just in this room that you just happen to find, Apples. So, and I mean, as it stands right now, you've got 9 out of 17 stamina and 4 out of 7 fear. That's not good. You can't afford to gain a lot more fear or you're gonna go mad. That skill and that luck. We could not, for those of you who missed the character creation, let me tell you, it was one to behold. We were terrible. We rolled a 1 for skill, a 1 for luck, and a 1 for fear, and a 5 for stamina. It was horrible. It really was bad. Yes, sure, absolutely, Ned. So, you go to this house because your car is broken down. You go to this house hoping for assistance, and of course it turns out to be a very creepy house. You meet this guy, and you see some cultists or something, these guys dressed in robes talking about some ceremony. When you go into the front and you meet the guy, you end up drinking something which is drugged, basically. When you wake up, you manage to escape your bonds, and then you ran into a ghostly woman who explained that you were in this house of hell, basically, run by this demon cult. And that the only way you can defeat the Lord of Droomer, the Earl, is by using something called a Chris Knife. So you need to find the Chris Knife, and then that way you'll be able to defeat him. So that's basically where you are right now. I know, right? Seriously. Okay. All right, 10 people say let's rest. Let's do it. You sit on the bed, trying to work out how on earth you can escape from the place. The room you are now in seems safe enough, and the rest refreshes you, increasing your stamina by 2 points. Yay! We're up to 11 stamina points, huzzah! But a few moments later, the wind whistling through the curtains attracts your attention. You glance over towards the window. Okay, I think that's an achievement. But I swear that what I thought that said was, you gained 30 fear points. And I was like, welp. I swear to God. What's up, Shadow? How you doing, man? I thought that was not a Steam achievement. I thought that was saying you have gained, or like whatever, an achievement. I thought that was you gained 30 fear points. Jesus. A soft voice is calling your name. You leap back against a wall while along the room a strange shape is forming. A human figure is passing through the very wall itself and entering the room. At least the figure is almost human, but its head is missing. As it materializes before you, the voice becomes clearer. It comes from a head that is carried not on the apparition's shoulders, but in its hand, which hangs down at its side. The sight is horrible, and ghostly blood drips onto the carpet from the severed head. You gain 2 fear points. Will you stay to hear what the ghost has to say, or will you run from the room? I guess you're already scared, so... You were gently startled. I know, right? I was not, like, freaked out. That wasn't, like, a jump scare. That was me being like, oh, crap, we're done. I was like, 30 fear points? That's what I thought happened. Watch, he's like, I am actually just an employee of Party City, and this is just a costume. Lose 10 fear points. You're like... Oh, sorry about that. I should have it on that side. Apologize. Yeah, just stay frozen with fear, not knowing what to do. There you go. See, now everyone's just like, you know, fear, 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 fear. Are we much enough? I don't actually think that you voted, Lego. I just see choose. I don't see an actual number.
Make me a peanut butter and jelly sandwich now, puny human, or prepare to face my wrath. Whoa.
All right. Last call for the vote. There you go. Last call for the vote, and... kill it. What's up, Gamer Main? What's going on, Gamer?
Make it chunky and not too much jam.
Fifteen votes for listening to the ghost. All right. The disembodied head speaks.
Prepare yourself for death, miserable mortal. It gloats. For the evil that is in this place cannot be escaped. The House of Druma has drawn you here for one purpose. Before the night is out, you will join me and my companions in the Netherworld. Our fate will be yours. You will forever haunt the place that has caused your death!
With these words, a mocking laughter fills the room. The apparition turns back through the wall, and as it does, the laughter fades. But the fight gives you 2 fear points. This horrible scene... and the knowledge of your impending death is just too much for you, and you have reached your maximum fear score. You die of fright. If you will excuse me for just one moment, chat. Just give me 1 second here. Just give me 1 second. This is an important ritual, and it must be maintained. Just give me 1 second. Nathan Lame, it was a good run, Nathan Lame. You had the chance, Nathan Lame. You had the chance to live, to survive, to do what it took, to survive this house of hell. But sadly, Nathan Lame, you were never very strong, very wise, very smart, or very brave. And when you saw the Headless Horseman, the time had come to lose your head as well. And in this life, there are times, Nathan Lame, when you just have to carry on. Try to survive. Try to make it through this world. One fading, fainting step at a time. You couldn't do that this time, Nathan Lame, because you stayed to listen to the Headless Horse Ghost. But we will soldier on in your absence, Nathan Lame. We will do what we can to survive, to carry on without you. Until that time, we bid you a kind and loving adieu. Okay. Right, where were we then? all right. Death time, people. It did not work out. We really are. We really are impressionable. It's true. All right. Oh, my goodness. All right, where were we? All right, the last time that we saved, we were here in the... Yes, thank you. Oh, my gosh. The last time that we were here... Can I be the eulogist for your funeral? I'll do what I can, Lego. Yes, yes. Oh, I unironically love bagpipes. Bagpipes are awesome. Let me just say, separate from everything else, bagpipes playing Amazing Grace, that is no joke, man. I'm telling you right now. Actually, I think it was longer than 45, Private. I want to say it was like an hour and 15, but yeah. Man, that fear, though. Okay. So again, here's the choices, guys. So we are bookmarked now here. We can either enter the Balthus room. If we die again, we may have to reroll, but we'll see. So we can either enter the... Yes, exactly. It's right there. Oh my god, it's right. And that leads up to Star Trek 3, The Search for Nathan. Okay. Okay, sounds good, gent. All right, here we go. So you can either enter the Balthus room, you can go through the other door, or ignore those doors and continue around the landing. So let me... Let me set up the poll. All right, what's it gonna be? All right, sounds good, Lee. Good luck with that, man. Keep continued luck and good wishes towards getting better fast, man. What's it gonna be, guys? Why are you going into the Room of Doom? All right, what's it going to be? And yes, so one of the things you guys will have to do as we play through this is you'll have to remember whether something was good or bad. So you'll have to remember whether or not it's a positive going into that room or not. So just keep that in mind. So do you guys remember what was in that room? Do people remember? All right, what's going to be the choice, guys? We going into that room or not? This was the zombie room, yes. Hi, Frosty. How you doing? So the choices right now are as follows. Right now it is, and actually Rap is changing to two. So right now we have two votes for Balthus and three votes for going through the other door. So two votes for Balthus, three votes for going through the other door, and one vote for ignoring both doors. Because Rap has changed her vote. So what have we got, guys? Anyone else? Avoid the zombies. So again, if you guys want to do that, make sure to choose your option that you want. Choice one is to, if you vote exclamation point, choose space one. Then you enter the Balthus room. If you vote choose two, exclamation point choose two, you go through the other door. Exclamation point choose three, ignore both doors, and continue round the landing. So what's it going to be? Nice, Frosty, nice. Salad and pasta, good stuff. A solid meal. What are we looking at, guys? What's it gonna be? Choose two. My guess is I'm going for another... I'm probably going for another 2.5 hours, I would guess. Shadow. The door with no zombies. All right, last call. Private Palmer goes choose three. Last call. Your last choice, here we go. Cool. All right. So remember, Rapscallion changed her vote. So that's three votes to ignore. Let's see. So we've got three votes to go through the other door. So let's do it. The door opens into a narrow passageway, which ends at a window. There's a door halfway along the left-hand side, and a sign on the door identifies it as the Diabolus room. So try the Diabolus door, investigate the window instead, or go back through the door and continue along the landing. Yes, Flat. Rapscallion changed her vote. Yes. Rapscallion changed her vote to go through the other door. Now remember, by the way, remember about this, that when you first saw the Headless Ghost, you took two fear points right there. So obviously you can't stay and talk to the ghost, but you took two fear points right at the very beginning. So that would lead you to six fear points out of seven. So I'm just letting you know that, like, you know, from a fear point of view, you're already not in a great position. So just keep that in mind. So I'm just letting you guys know. Okay, so go ahead and vote on that choice. And yeah, always make sure to choose, put in the vote afterwards. And that's a good point, Flat, swapping two fear for two stamina. Change it to two. Okay, Apples. Yeah, I'll show you guys exactly what our current position is. 13 out of 17 stamina. We've got 2 out of 7 fear right now. So this is where we're at. So we could gain 2 more stamina, but then we'd be up to 4 fear, basically. So that's where we are right now. All right. There we go. Welcome into everybody, by the way, who's here. I hope you like what you see in here. If you are new and if you are a regular of mine, then welcome back in. Pleasure to see all of you. If you are new to the stream, please make sure to give it a follow if you like what you see in here. My name is Arvin Elleron. I play all sorts of different games, but I tend to focus on narrative and story-based games because I'm an author myself. So I just finished with Legend of Grimrock 2, which was great. We're playing this game, and next up is going to be my first crack at Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney, a game I've never played before. Once that's done, I'm going to finish up my Ultima Underworld run, and then I'm going to move on to either Trails of Sky, which is possible, or possibly continuing, possibly Assassin's Creed 4, or maybe Dragon Age Inquisition. I didn't want to be playing it right out of the gate, because I don't want to be competing with 80 other streamers. Literally, there were 80 people streaming this game earlier today. I don't want to be competing with 80 other people on it, but it's a game that I'm definitely going to want to play down the line. So, yes, Bad Rats. You should check out the boss fight highlight, Thorg. It was pretty awesome at the end, so... Okay. Yes, we have terrible stats, is the case. That was really cool. Okay, try Diablo Store 2, investigate the Window 7. Yeah, it's definitely a great game. My game of the year, Thor. Curtains are drawn across the window and you approach cautiously. You gingerly pat the folds in the curtain and are relieved to find nothing there. Although they seem to be safe, you are still on your guard as you draw them apart. As you do so, a thunderclap booms outside and makes you jump. But you are safe. A perfectly ordinary window is uncovered. However, the heavy iron bars on the outside are a little worrying. Through the window, you can see nothing but the rain running down the pane of glass. But curiously, the rain is avoiding one area. Could it be that the wind is blowing the rain away from this one corner? You bend down to take a closer look. Written in the condensation which is formed on the glass is a message. You read three words: Mordana in Abaddon. You repeat this message to yourself and then rub it off the window in case anyone else should see it. This message may be useful to you and you will realize when it is. Now you must head back to the landing and turn left. All right, I think that counts for a bookmark. Good job, guys. A short distance further on, you come to the top of the main staircase, which leads downward. Immediately opposite the staircase is an unmarked door. Do you wish to go downstairs? Maybe you wish to try the unmarked door, or will you continue round the landing? All right, do you want to go downstairs? Do you want to try the unmarked door or continue round the landing? What's it going to be? You've been round the landing, but it's a long landing, Apples. it's a pretty large floor, so... I don't think you came from the unmarked door, but I don't remember, to be honest with you. You might have. I don't actually remember, because I think it may have been a different door, actually. Right, you started in the middle of the upstairs, went left, so I don't know how far that is until you actually got to the staircase. But up here, you've actually gotten some information that's useful so far. You've gotten the fact that, you've gotten this thing about, Mordana in Abaddon. You found out that you met the ghost up here. You found a frayed rope and a letter opener. So, and you've only lost 4 stamina and you've gained 2 fear. So not too bad. Yeah, the headless wraith was in the Balthus room. Yeah. Oh no, the headless wraith. The ghost was in the Balthus room. Flat Hat, the woman, the ghost of the woman. But the headless ghost was in the Diablos room. Was it? Actually, was that a zombie? That's right. The headless guy was with Diablo. I think the headless ghost was Diablo's room. The zombie might have been the Balthus room. They were both pretty bad. Yeah. And then you found the... I think it's an A. Adiyadan, possibly the room. The Adiyadan room was where the ghost of the woman was. So... All right. Okay, go downstairs, 0 votes, try the unmarked door, 7 votes. You step into a small storeroom and close the door behind you. There are shelves on the left and right walls on which various household objects are stored. In front of you, in the wall facing the door, is another door. Will you search through the things on the shelves, try the door opposite, or return to the landing? Let's see. All right, search through things on shelves, try the door opposite, or return to the landing. Knickknacks. Choose 12. Choose all the things. So, go ahead and make your vote, guys. Go ahead and make your vote. Now is the time to vote. If you want to search through the things on the shelves, try the door opposite, or return to the landing. What are your choices? What's it going to be? Got a number of people in here now, so stand and be counted. Knickknacks, paddywax. Give your dog a bone. Loot the broom. Okay, here we go. I know, goat MMO, I know, right? I saw that. It's crazy stuff. Okay, 7 votes to search through the things on the shelves. Various items of crockery, cutlery, and food are kept in the storeroom, including a sharp meat knife, which you hide under your coat to use as a weapon in the future. This sharp knife adds 3 skill points in a fight. Ooh. Okay, so we don't have the letter opener, now we have a sharp knife, but still. On one shelf you find several cloves of garlic, which you also take. Nice. There's also an unlabeled bottle of white liquid on another shelf. Do you wish to drink the liquid? Ignore the liquid. Actually, let me throw a bookmark in here. Do you wish to drink the liquid? Ignore the liquid and try the door at the back of the storeroom, or leave by the door you entered. So not bad, guys. We got a sharp knife and some garlic. Okay, here we go. Exactly, Thorg. Exactly. All right, so drink the liquid, try the door at the back of the storeroom, or return to the landing. Shadowed says, do not drink, please. And everyone's like, choose. Poor Shadowed. Shadowed's like, don't drink. Everyone's like, I think we should drink. Shadowed's like, you fools. I mean, I guess I bookmarked it anyway, so... I guess the worst case scenario, you have to listen to Amazing Grace again, right, Shadowed? Who's with me?
Who's with me?
You can assume the liquid is courage. Sure, it's like milk and magnesium. You know? So many delicious white liquids that exist. There's milk. There's rice milk. There's almond milk. There's milk and magnesium. There's latte. Creamy milk. Lots of choices. When we die. Shadow. The liquid actually opens your eyes to the nether room, gives you sight beyond sight.
Thunder. 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 Thundercats. Oh! Sword of Ages. Give me sight beyond sight.
A white Russian, yes. Yes, that is true. Soy milk in the House of Hell. Well, the House of Hell wants to bring you into the demons, but it wants to do so while being environmentally responsible. The Earl of Dreamer is actually a vegan, so... Like, when he actually sacrifices people, he sacrifices a tofurkey instead of an actual, you know... He only eats vegetarians, Rap. Exactly, be curious. We're lactose intolerant. Drink liquid, 6 votes, door at the back of the storeroom. Let's drink the liquid. You taste the liquid. It is white wine. You drink some more and it warms you. You start to feel a little lightheaded and dizzy. Then suddenly you feel a stab of pain in your stomach and you double over. But there is no relief from this pain because you have drunk poisoned wine. In a few moments you will lose consciousness and in 5 minutes you will be dead. You will never make tomorrow's appointment. After all, the end. Nathan Lame, you were warned once not to drink strange white liquids. It was never going to end well for you, Nathan Lame. But you decided the time had come to ignore those warnings. You decided that the time had come to prove that you were not going to let anyone else tell you what to do. You were going to take charge of your own destiny, Nathan Lame. And that's exactly what you did. And as a consequence, you are now lying in pain, and then dead on the floor. But in this life, Nathan Lame, although you may die because of milk, although you may die because you didn't have the strength required, at least you went out on your own terms, Nathan Lame. At least you told yourself, I am not going to be taking orders from anybody else. I'll drink that white liquid. I'll pass to the next realm. And no one's gonna stop me. Godspeed, Nathan Lame. You didn't listen to advice. You didn't listen to wisdom. But you did it your way.
Good times, good times.
Death number two, people. Alrighty. Okay, where were we? Fortunately for you guys... Hold on a second. Fortunately for you guys, we were right there. Screw this house of hell. Drink when we die. Exactly, exactly. Needs more Danny Boy. Oh, man. Okay. So now that we've done that, I think we can all agree we shouldn't drink the liquid. So, your choices are... Needs more... Well, you know, the thing is, it's not the dice that killed us, Nogbad, except, well, the one time I guess you had too much fear. It's just like, you know, drinking liquid. You would have died regardless of what your strength was, you know? Exactly, gentlemen. I'm sorry. I'm not supposed to smile. That's true. It's terrible of me. You speak the truth, Net. I apologize for my insensitivity. Okay. So, your choices are to ignore the liquid and try the door, or return to the landing. Now remember, choose one is also ignoring the liquid. So choose both of them, ignore the liquid. Now it's just whether you try the other door. So try the other door or go back to the landing. Remember, you're not drinking the liquid. Choose one. Okay. So remember, choose two is return to the landing, but choose one is try the other door. In fact, you know what? Let me redo that. Let me redo that. I worded that confusingly. There we go. Here's a new poll. Do this again. Sorry about that, guys. New poll. Here we go. New poll. I just started a new poll. So this, you go. Either try the other door or return to the landing. I took the liquid out of it. Sorry. That was confusing. Everyone was like, God, no, not the liquid. I have heard about this war of mine, Nedowin, and I looked at it. It looks like it's something I might be interested in at some point. I don't really want to try it now, because it feels to me like it's like super depressing, and I'm not really in the mood for a super depressing game at the moment. It looks like a really interesting game that I might want to try. It almost looks a little bit like a cross between Valiant Hearts that I played earlier this year and Mark of the Ninja. Just something about the sort of side-scrolling sort of notion of it looks a little bit similar. I've heard many good things about it, and I may want to try it in the future, but not for a while, to be honest. Yeah, sorry about that, guys. So new poll was put up. So either to try the other door or return to the landing. So sorry about the poll confusion before. Hey, IK, what's up, man? What is going on, sir? Very close to Valiant Hearts? Okay. Yeah, I'm definitely going to be interested in playing it at some point. Definitely at some point, Net, but it's not going to be, like, it's not going to be the next few games, just because, as I say, I actually watched some gameplay videos of it. It looks cool, but I'm not in the mood for, like, super depressing at the moment, so I want to kind of give that a rest a little bit. But I will do it at some point. Oh, that's interesting, Flat. I guess we'll find out. I don't know if that does that, but good to see you, IK. I guess we will find out. It's brutal, yeah. Yeah, that's what I heard. That is what I heard. Okay, last call. If you guys are interested, last call. Yes. I know. Sometimes when you play these games, right, Apple? Sometimes you play these games and you're like, I'm so glad that I've never been in a deserted house with a death cult after me. Like, I just would be so screwed if I were ever facing a demon cult in a house in the middle of nowhere. I'm just saying. All right, last call, people, last call. And then we'll be taking a break here for 5 minutes. In another 5 minutes or so, we'll be taking a five-minute break to just stand up, walk around a little bit, and you guys can do that with me. We'll do that in about, about 10 minutes. So we'll do that in about 10 minutes. We'll take a five-minute break, all right? I know, IK. It's cold here too, man. It was like, I think it's like 30 degrees straight up right now in New York City, which is cold for this time in November. All right, 6 votes to try the other door, 2 votes to return. You step out of the storeroom into a hallway. To your left, the hallway enters at a door which leads into the Shaitan room. If you wish to try the Shaitan room, you can do that. Or you can go to the Mammon room, or you can go back to the landing through the storeroom. So, your choices are... Yeah, 30 degrees Fahrenheit, yep. Which is not cold, like, generally, except that for New York mid-November, it's kind of cold. Try the Shaitan room. Try the Mammon room, or go back to the landing. -3 with wind chill. There you go. There are your choices. Try the Shiten room, try the Mammon room, or go back to the landing.
Shiten.
Shiten. Mammon's money is a tarp. Ah, this is quite a battle. This is like, which demon do you want to check out? Right now we got a tie. Go ahead and make those votes, people. Make those votes happen. Shaitan is a bad creature. We'll get along famously. Shaitan. I think if we were Jehovah's Witness lost in this house of hell, we would have sort of shut down a while ago, is my guess. I don't know if you were on this playthrough, Apples, actually. I don't know. Oh, no kidding. Really, Net? You have not been in the Mammon room, I don't believe. No. I don't believe so. The Mammon machine in the Mammon room. Mammonogram, you mean? Is that what you're talking about? All right, here we go. Explains a whole lot, Jen, right? Explains a whole lot. Yes, indeed. And... ah, 4 votes for Shiten, 3 votes for Mammon. Shiten it is. You open the door and peer around. This room is a large, elegantly decorated bedroom with a 4-poster bed in one corner. There is a 3-piece suite in the center of the room facing a fireplace. A fire is smoldering, but the room appears to be empty. On the far side of the room, there are 2 more doors. No, it didn't, IK. No. Frost, yes, but not snow. Do you wish to go in or close the door and leave the room? All right, you're going to enter the room. Hold on a second. Enter the room. There it is. Enter the room or leave the room. What's it going to be? Enter the room or leave that room, peoples. Speaking of warm, it's getting warm in here.
It's getting hot in here, so I'm gonna take off my sweater. I am getting so hot, I'm gonna take my sweater off.
I think a 3-piece suite, actually, is like a chair. So it's like a chair, a sofa, and a chair, basically. So it's like this, right? It's like this. You see it, and it's like this. And then the guy goes like this. He goes... that's what happens. Exactly like that. It's just smirk. I don't know what to make of that money. That's funny. That's a little weird. It's like Tron Christmas, you know? Then I headbat the webcam. I do not have a cat. I should have a cat so I could be- I have a dog. But the thing is, my dog would not stay in my lap long enough for me to be petting her head. She'd be like, what are you doing? Okay. Okay, enter the room. You step inside and close the door quietly behind you. A soft click comes from the lock. As you step forward, a voice greets you. You look around, but you can see no one. The voice continues.
So, our visitor is inquisitive, eh? Or are you trying to leave the house? Perhaps our hospitality is not to your liking. Perhaps you would like to see some more, shall we say, amusements?
The eerie voice makes you nervous. You gain one fear point. Ah, fear points! Do you wish to stay and talk to the voice, or make a hasty exit through the door? Alright, there's your choice, guys. Talk to the voice or exit through the door. It was like, exit. Private's like, talk to the voice. It was like, GTFO. Oh, I'm sorry that it's buffering for you, Frosty. I'm not dropping any frames on my end. I'm sorry about that. Choose two. I don't like scary musings. Choose one. Choose one if fear not. I fear not. Choose one, urinate on the armchair to assert your dominance. I do. It's just like, I will happily talk to you, voice. Zip. Psst.
So, you have decided to urinate on my armchair. Perhaps you believe you're asserting your dominance, eh? I see you have marked your territory. Well played, chat. Well played.
The voice gains 5 fear points. good times. That's my default scary voice, gentlemen. God damn it.
So, you've decided to urinate on my armchair. You will pay for that.
Then all of a sudden it's Assassin's Creed 1. You know?
You pee on my armchair in my presence? That would cost you your life!
Thank you. Oh, man. 5 votes say to talk, 4 votes say to exit. All right. Aha. In front of you is a high-backed armchair facing the fire with its back towards you. A figure raises itself from the chair and turns to face you. The man is tall and pale with jet black hair. He wears a long black cape fastened across the neck with a gold clasp.
Yes, he says. So far you have fared well against the occupants of the house. But I believe you will find that your run of luck has come to an end. Step forward so I can see you urinate in my armchair again.
Will you step forward as he asks, or will you prepare to attack him? Garlic! You do have garlic, it's true. You do have garlic.
Clearly someone who has urinated on my armchair would not also have garlic. Next you are going to tell me that you enjoyed a meal of curry and other pungent foods. I believe I can resist all of your temptations, including both your urine and your garlic.
Oh, gosh. Yes, Private, I will change it. It's like... I'll change that vote when I actually see what it is, yeah. You have to eat the garlic first and... You think you'll have time to do all that? Yeah.
Let me make you some pasta arrabbiata. The time has come for you to taste some of my pesto chicken Alfredo. You will enjoy some delicious couscous.
Rap, this is not Twilight, okay? Rapscallion, secretly a Twilight fan, confirmed. Hashtag Rapscallion Twilight fan. No, hashtag Rapscallion Team Edward. Okay, let's see what chat has decided.
The slander!
Rapsky and Team Edward. Couscous. Alright, everyone says to prepare to attack. How will you attack the man? Will you use a weapon? Or, chat, do you have anything else you can use? Will you use a weapon or do you have anything else you can use? Ah, Interview the Vampire. Yes, yes, yes. Little Tom Cruise action. Oh, thank you, Frosty. So freaking firings. Everyone's like, choose two. You're like,
the power of garlic compels you!
You guys are so excited about this garlic. I think it's because, like, Nathan Lane was such a terrible character that the fact that he has leverage over some creature, you're just like, yes. Can I throw my fighting fantasy book at him? That might have an effect. That might have effect. Attack him with Nathan's Emmy. There you go. I've actually met Nathan Lane on the backstage of the producers, actually. Him and Matthew Broderick when it was on Broadway. 12 votes. You have something else to use. Do you have any garlic with you? Yes, you do. You pull the garlic out of your pocket and hold it up before the man. His expression changes from one of confidence to a look of fright. As you suspected, this vampire cannot bear to be near raw garlic. Sweat breaks out on his forehead and he backs off towards the bed. He is heading for one of the other doors in the room. You hurriedly look around, trying to decide the best way out. Will you try the door on the left? Or will you try the door on the right that he was heading for? Or you can turn around and dash quickly for the door you came in through. And I'm actually going to bookmark it here. So your choices are door on the left, door on the right that he was heading for, or the door that you came in through. So let me write that down. Let me mark that as a poll. Alright, door on the left, door on the right, which he's heading for, door through which you came. Charge at the vampire head first. You just take the garlic and you just like put it in your mouth and you charge directly at him. That's what you do. That's basically the equivalent. I see a child behind me. Aha!
Hi, beautiful. Look at this.
Wow, guys, let me go full screen for a minute. Look at this, guys. Here. Back up. Look at that outfit, huh?
Wow.
That's the outfit that Grandma got you, right?
Gretchen.
Oh, Gretchen got this for you?
Yes.
I thought Grandma got it for you. Let me see.
Gretchen.
Wow. That's crazy. That's gorgeous. That looks really beautiful, sweetie.
Grandma got it for Christmas.
That's really, really beautiful.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
That is really... Ah! That's amazing. I love it. I'm gonna be done in about probably not for like an hour and 45 minutes or so. So, because I'm gonna be done about 7 o'clock.
That's
your mom. Yeah, but that's kind of what the way it often works there as well. Isn't that a nice dress? Yeah, her grandma was in. Here, let me lean forward a bit. Her grandma was in. There you go. Her grandma was in Chicago over the weekend, so she came back and. She got my daughter. She got my daughter this beautiful dress. So, Apple says you're wearing red and green. Yeah, Christmas for the upcoming holiday season for sure.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. All my buddies are running right up the deck. Hey!
I like how that fits the house of hell that we're in. All of a sudden, you're just singing this at the vampire. The vampire's like, I'm sorry. That's what we're playing. We're playing like one of the game books, like this one. Yeah, it's right. It says, will you? And do you know what that third word is? What's that last letter? No, what's the last letter? Why? So, trip. No, what's the last letter?
Well, actually, we're not practicing that.
Okay.
So I don't know what it says.
It's try. Try.
Will you try the dog?
Not the dog. It's actually or, so door. That's actually left. Man, this kid is starting to read. Amazing. 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 Yep. She's recognizing these smaller words now and stuff like that. That's awesome.
To look
this one? Vampire. It says vampire. Oh, as you suspected, this vampire cannot bear to be near raw garlic. Because vampires don't like garlic. Did you know that?
No.
Mm-hmm. So if you ever see a vampire, make sure you use garlic.
Well, vampires are not alive.
Vampires are not alive? That's true. That's true. That's exactly it. You just throw garlic at him. Yep, that's exactly right. Let's see what chat actually chose.
Chose for what?
They were deciding what to do with him. Do a kid's version of one of these? Oh, yeah, for sure. Let's see. 3 votes say door on the left, 10 votes to door on the right. All right.
I vote for throw the garlic.
You wrote for throw the garlic. Well, actually, you know what? If you vote for throw the garlic, then guess what? That actually worked out because it says, you hurl the garlic at the vampire and dash for the door. He shrieks, trying to brush off the garlic as you fling it open. It opens into a cupboard, but a rather unusual one. The back wall is slid aside, revealing a secret passageway. The vampire is rising to his feet again, so you decide to risk what lies ahead and step through into the passageway, slamming both doors behind you. Well done. Well done, chat. Okay, sounds good, Frosty. Yeah, I highly recommend this. This is good stuff. Good work, guys. The passageway is narrow and only the faintest glow lights your way. After a short distance, you come to a staircase which leads downward. What's up, Sarah Morpheus? Yeah, it is very difficult. It's true. Yeah, it's definitely difficult. But chat's doing a good job so far with the help of my daughter here. Let's see. After a short distance, you come to a staircase which leads downwards. Slowly and cautiously, you go down the stairs. After a dozen or so steps, you reach another landing, and you may follow them down further by turning. Or you may try a door in the wall of the landing. So keep following the stairs or try the door. So let's see. hole.
I choose keep on falling distance. Wait, are you just reading this book?
Yes, but Chad is making decisions about them. About choices to make. Ah, rat bag. Ah, rat bag. What's up? Welcome back, Shadow. So, keep following the stairs or try the door? Choose two, all the doors. Try the door! That says check input volume. That's so I can make sure that I'm not being too loud when I speak, so that chat doesn't go, ah, my ears. Because they're all listening. Remember, they're all watching on their computers everywhere? So, or on their phones or things like that. And see how they're all making choices now? They're choosing like two or one. So a lot of them are choosing to try the door. There's a couple people choosing to go down the stairs, but a lot of people are trying to choose choosing the door.
Me too. I agree with the people that are choosing the door.
You do agree with people that are choosing the door? Okay, it looks like they're going to win. Choose two and then check the input volume on the landing. We'll do it, Kadrian. The guy comes out. I see you have urinated on the landing and checked the door. You will pay. Oh, man. If anyone has military experience, always secure the first possible room before moving onwards. Luke, I am your door. All right, let's see what the results were. That was my kid. She's amazing. Okay, 12 votes to try the door. The door opens and you find yourself in a small room. There is another door leading off the room, but in front of you is a strange sight which catches your attention. A shimmering haze seems to be hanging on the wall, almost like a curtain of sparkling water. I just realized I blew past my break. I'll take it at the bottom of the hour, so give me about 10 minutes and we'll take my break. Sorry. You step up to investigate and gingerly hold out your finger to touch it. Your finger passes right through. Plucking up your courage, you poke your head into the haze. On the other side, you realize what has happened. Your head has emerged through a large mirror into a reception room. On the wall opposite is a huge mural of a country scene, and standing in the middle of the room are a table and six chairs. The sound of voices outside the door startles you and you draw your head back. Will you wait until the way is clear and step through the mirror? Do you want to try the other door in this little room that's behind the mirror, or go back to the stairs and follow them down? Thank you, Private. Yeah, she's a keeper. So let's see. Oh, thanks, Akadrian. I appreciate it, man. If you guys are not already doing so, please make sure to follow Akadrian. He's a cool guy, runs a cool stream that's sort of education-oriented, learning from video games, and I'm obviously a huge fan of that sort of thing. So definitely give that guy a follow if you've not already done so. Actually, can somebody... Akadrian, before you leave, just link your channel in chat, man, so people can follow you, or you can just click on his name and follow as well. So do one of those choices. So yeah, go ahead and vote, guys. Sorry about that. Just needed to get that clear. Alright, hang on a second. Okay. All right, let's see what we got. Okay, step through the mirror when the coast is clear, winds. All right. You wait until there is silence in the drawing room and step carefully back through the mirror into the room. The coast is clear. You walk over to the door and leave the room. You leave the room cautiously and look around in the hallway. There is no one about. There is a door to your left, which you may try, or you may turn right and follow the hallway around. All right, so either try a door to the left, guys, or turn right and follow the hallway around. Decide what you guys are going to do. What's it going to be? Try the door to the left or turn right and follow the hallway around. My wife just saw a picture that my mother-in-law texted her of my daughter wearing that outfit that I just showed you guys, and my wife texted back, "I'm gonna cry." It's tough, I'll tell you what, guys. Being a parent, when you start watching your kids grow up, it's a wonderful thing. Like, I can't even explain how wonderful it is, but it's also a little rough in its own way. It's wonderful and a little rough, too. So, it's because, you know, she's always going to be my little girl, but, you know, she's grown up. She's going to be 7 in January. That is mind-blowing to me. She's going to be 7 years old. That's crazy. Like, 7 years old is where I really start remembering stuff. I remember stuff about my own childhood. I remember a couple of things. I remember a flash of something when I was, like, 2, and then I remember some things when I was, like, 5 and 6, like, flashes here and there. But really, 7 is where I really start to imagine, like, ah, this is what it is. She's 6 right now, flat. So, yeah. Have I bought my shotgun? I've been polishing that thing for years, Apples. What are you talking about? Yeah. It's great, though. I mean, she's great. She's an amazing kid. She really is. I've said many times it's an honor to be your father. I really feel that way. So, it's not always easy. It's not always easy to be a parent, but cool stuff. I don't think Money was banned, was he? I think he was banned. Okay, here we go. Alright, try the door to the left. The door is locked and you will not be able to open it. You turn around and follow the hallway. The hallway widens. You walk across to another hallway and continue in the direction you are walking until you reach 2 doors opposite each other. Door to the right or door on the left? And this will be the last decision before I take my next break. What's it going to be? Door on the right or door on the left, guys? This will be the last decision that we make before I take my next 5-minute break. Every so often when I look down like this, it's usually because I'm actually checking I'm checking the book version, so. All right, sounds good, Glog. Thanks for stopping by, man. Appreciate it, Glog. Catch you soon, dude. Glog's another guy you guys should be following. He's my resident Linux expert, too. And all-around good guy, but... Okay. All right. 6 votes for left, 3 votes for right. So, left it is. The door is locked. The handle and lock are part of an ornate metal plate. We do not have a cast iron key with you, so we must try the door opposite and quickly because you can hear footsteps approaching from the hallway. The door opens and you enter. Oh, God. Oh, God. Guess where we are. Guess where we are, guys. The door opens and you enter the kitchen. The room is empty and immaculately tidy, with all the knives, pots, and pans hanging in neat rows along the walls. A double sink is set under a window next to a large cooker and fridge. A great square table stands in the center of the room. There are 2 doors. One leads outside and the other looks like a pantry door. A large bunch of keys lies on top of the cooker. Oh, gosh. Yep. You are dead. You cannot escape the kitchen. But just for fun, while I take my break, you guys can decide which way you want to die. All of these ways will lead you to death. It's a good thing I didn't bookmark until well before this point, but still. Oh my god, the kitchen doom. You cannot be stopped. Okay, so I will set up the poll. You can see which way you want to die, just for fun. And then when I get back, we'll go through our death, and then we'll go back again. Okay. All right, guys. While you were thinking about that, I'm going to go take my break. Thank you guys all so much, as always, for watching this stream. I really do appreciate it. If you like what you see in here, please make sure to follow. Please make sure to tweet out the stream. Join my YouTube for past broadcasts and join the Steam group for more community interaction of the lovely kind you've been experiencing tonight. It's 5:30, so I will be back in 5 minutes. I'm going to get up, stretch my legs, stuff like that. I recommend that you do the same thing. And then I will be back at you guys in 5 more minutes where we will see what creative way we're going to die in the kitchen. So decide which way you want to die in the kitchen. I'll be back at you guys in 5 minutes. See you in a bit. Okay. All right, welcome back, everybody. And yeah, I saw the thing about it. Shadowed is going to be back on in a little bit, and Shadowed might be able to help address it as well. Let me see. Give me one second here while I contact him. Oh, okay, what's up, Shadowed? Okay, I just got in touch with him. Okay, welcome back, everybody. Here we are. Welcome back, everyone. Okay, have you decided which way you want to die? Let's see which way everyone wants to die. How did everyone want to die? Okay, grab bunch of keys on the cooker. That's a good one. You pick up the bunch of keys and start to flick through them. Ugh! You scream loudly and drop the keys on the floor, for they are red hot and you have severely burnt your hand. You were using your weapon hand and must lose 3 stamina points and 2 skill points, but if you wish, you may test your luck. The scream and clatter of the falling key have made quite a noise. All right, guys, you gonna test luck or not? No, I have to readjust the filter, actually. I know, right, Apples? Why couldn't we see they were red hot? I know. Because the kitchen is doom, man. Because the kitchen is doom, that's why. Because doom is what it is. It just is. There's no other word for it. Doom is what it is. Tell you, man, this book is brutal. It really brutal. White Han's understandable. Red Han. I know. You're right, Apples. I know it, man. The keys were already red as a defense mechanism. Yep. Doom. Test luck. Woo! That luck roll, though. You weren't using your weapon hand after all, and you only lose 1 stamina point. We do have enough stamina, so... Your fears are confirmed when the door opens. The noises attracted the attention of some mysterious friends of the Earl of Droomer. 4 men enter the room, all dressed in white gowns and wearing goat's heads to conceal their faces. They are armed with knives and lengths of wood. It would be foolish to resist them. Grabbing your wrist, they take you downstairs into the cellars. There you enter a room in which there are 4 prison cells. 3 are already occupied, but the 4th is empty. You will be detained here at the Earl's pleasure. Your adventure has ended. The end. Nathan Lame, you believed that you could survive by entering the kitchen. But as you should know, the kitchen is doom. There is no escaping the kitchen. There is no surviving the kitchen. The kitchen is an automatic, permanent, and forever loss. No amount of cooking, no amount of knowledge, no amount of experience in the kitchen will ever keep you from surviving the kitchen. And in this life, there will be times when the kitchen will beckon to you. It will say, I have delicious food, delicious smells. It's worth your while to come in here. But you must resist, Nathan Lane. You must resist with every fiber of your Broadway Tony-nominated and Emmy-nominated being. Your only chance is to avoid the kitchen. Stay out. Be be in the dining room, the bathroom, the living room, the den, the solarium. But for God's sake, in the name of all that is holy, Nathan Lane, avoid the kitchen. For the kitchen.
Oh God, Amazing Grace, love it,
absolutely love it.
good times. All right, fortunately you guys will be happy to know that we were bookmarked well before that, so that's one good thing working in our favor. Oops, sorry, let me get the volume.
Yes, money could explain. Yeah, money could explain what it is. Money, you could explain what's going on to Lawbot. So, money, can you explain to Law? Law just checked in. Can you explain to Law what happened? He's not talking about the game, he's talking about the bot. Can you explain what happened with the bot? And I don't want to do a ton of testing of it, but just sort of let, you know as well. Okay. Meanwhile, while they are arranging dealing with that, let's go on with the adventure. So, here we are. The passageway is narrow and only the faintest glow lights your way. After a short distance, you come to a staircase which leads downwards. Slowly and cautiously, you go down the stairs. So you can either follow them down. So either follow the stairs down or try the door in the wall of the landing. So what's it gonna be, guys? Continue down the stairs? Or try the door? Okay. All right. Any other choices? What have we got here? Right now, we only have a couple of people who are choosing. So, what else have we got? Do that vote, guys. Go ahead and vote. Do you want to follow the stairs down or try the door in the wall of the landing? Go ahead and make that vote. Alright, go ahead and make that vote. Decide what you want to do. If you want to try those, go down the stairs or try the door in the wall of the landing. If you can remember what we did last time, that would be helpful to avoid the Kitchen of Doom. Because the kitchen cannot be stopped. Because the kitchen is doom, as we've talked about before. Oh, Twitch is down? Oh, wow, okay. Alright, do not refresh, folks. Don't refresh whatever you do, because Twitch apparently is down. Twitch is down. That's not cool. I'm gonna go check that while you guys are making your final votes.
Just checking this quickly while you guys are doing this. All right, hang on a second. Follow your. Okay, I was just checking to make sure that was true. Okay, here we go. The API, the thing that runs 99% of Twitch, is down. Why am I getting these follows all of a sudden? You know what? This follower notification? I bet I know what this is. Hold on a second. I don't know. This may be a mess up with the API, because I shouldn't be getting all these follower notifications all of a sudden. I bet this is... Sometimes this happens. Yeah, I'm going to cut that off. Sometimes that happens with the API, so... My goodness. Okay. That's proof that there's something fouling up with it. When you have a follower notification, you sort of expect it to happen. So, all right, follow the stairs down. The narrow stairway splits and offers you two ways down. Will you choose the left-hand stairs or the right-hand stairs? I know, exactly. It's an invisible raid. Yeah, I think when the API goes back up, it affects the follower notification in some weird way, I believe. So, all right. So, left-hand stairs or right-hand stairs? Okay, so they fixed it. Cool. Which way is it going to be, guys? Left-hand stairs or right-hand stairs? Yeah, exactly. I have lots of people who have been following me. It's been very exciting, but not in this particular case. I like it when the follows are real. We've been having lots of great follows. I'm very happy about that, but... I'm very happy about the number of follows. Okay. Left-hand stairs or right-hand stairs? I've got right-hand, left-hand. Right-hand, 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 left-hand. Okay, cool. Well, I am still here. We're maintaining. We're keeping it up. Okay. All right, last call. And let's do it up. The answer was... Sure, I can bookmark. Sure. Let's see. Right-hand stairs it is. You follow the stairs downwards. Running across the bottom is a passageway. You turn right and follow it until you reach a dead end with two doors facing each other on opposite sides of the wall. Do you want to try the door on the left, the door on the right, or turn around and head back? I know, it's only you can only do like one bookmark at a time is the thing, so either door on the left, door on the right, or head back. Door on the left, door on the right, or head back. So we've got choose one, door on the left, choose two, door on the right, and choose three is head back. I know. Left, right, left, right, right, left, right, left. Yep. It's exactly what it is, man. Go left, go right, go right, go left, all over the place. That is the idea. All All right, go ahead and make that choice.
Make that change.
I'm looking at the man in the mirror. I'm asking him to change his ways, yeah.
Can you die because you can't make a choice? You could just sit here forever, that's true.
Telling you, man, House of Hell is really rough. It's brutal.
Brutal.
Choose two. Illuminated Night. I want to see if that's a real follow or if that's the API being fiddled with. Possible thanks to Illuminated Night. Ah! It looks like it does actually exist and that was legitimate. Thank you for the follow, Illuminated Night. I appreciate Illuminated Night. That was a legitimate follow, everybody. So welcome into the stream. Pleasure to have you here. Thank you for the follow. Welcome to the Arvanauts. Yeah, there is only one way to complete it. It's rough. I am real. Nice. Welcome in. Thanks. Welcome to the Arvanauts, Illuminated. Hey, what's up, Poke? I like the name, Illuminated. Welcome in, Poke. What's going on, man? How you been? You missed it, Poke. We've been playing, man. Door on the right it is. The door is not locked. You open it cautiously and poke your head inside. You have found a food store of some kind. The room is lined with shelves with various foodstuffs on them. Bread, dried meats, cheese, fruit, dried fish, wine, red and white, and cakes are all neatly stacked on the shelves. If you need to restore some of your stamina, you may choose any of these to eat. Yeah, I know, it's true, Net. Do you eat bread, dried meats, cheese, fruit, dried fish, white wine, red wine, cakes? Or don't take any of them. This should be a fun one. We're going to get a good test of the poll of the bot here. All right, there we go. Vote 1 for bread, 2 for dried meats, 3 for cheese, 4 for fruit, 5 for dried fish, 6 for white wine, 7 for red wine, 8 for cakes, 9 for none of them. And keep in mind that the last time you had white wine and this happened, so. Oh, it sucks, Div. Sorry, man. So go ahead and cast your vote, guys. Decide if you want to eat any of them. You can choose none of them. 9 is none. Or you could eat one of them. It's up to you. What's up, Arkbound? Hey, what's up, Shabby? What's going on, peoples? Bread is ahead of food. I feel like I'm back in Legend of Grimrock. Shadowed Mage Illuminated Knight. That's funny. That's funny. I dig it. Welcome back in, everybody. I saw that Twitch had a couple of minor issues, but we're back on track now. We need some wine with our cheese. Yeah, welcome to House of Hell, guys. Welcome to House of Hell. Exactly, Thord.
Red wine just like blood.
Alright, go ahead and make your vote. You guys can vote for whatever you like. And then we will see what the results are. Let's take a look at what the results are currently. Right now, the results are, there is one vote for bread has one vote, dried meat has 3 votes, cheese has 5 votes, fruit has none, dried fish has 2 votes, white wine has 1 vote, red wine has 1 vote, none of them has 1 vote. So right now, cheese is winning.
bread is head of everything means the most important food. Oh, interesting. Interesting. Well, I guess it would be too, right? I mean, bread was a critically important thing. That's interesting, huh? Okay, I'll buy that. Okay, we gotta vote for fruit. We gotta vote for... Let's keep classy with white wine. I don't know if you can, apples. I don't know. I would say vote for the one that, you'll see whether you get a choice to try anything else. It's not clear. Sometimes they'll let you choose other things. Sometimes you get to choose one thing and that's it. So it totally depends. All right, sounds good. See you, Private. Thanks for stopping by, man. Good to see you, man. What's up, Paulo? Eat everything. Okay, here we go. Last call. If you've ever wanted to eat one of these things, state it now or forever hold your peace. All the things is not a valid poll option. Yeah, there's no vote for eat all the things, sadly. It does say to take what you like. Hollow, to vote for that, Hollow, to vote for cakes, you want to type in exclamation point choose 8. So choose space 8. You need to do exclamation point choose space 8. There we go. So, 1 vote for bread, 3 votes for dried meats, 5 votes for cheese, 1 vote for fruit, 2 votes for dried fish, white wine, 2 votes for white wine, 1 vote for red wine, 1 vote for cakes, and 1 vote for none of them. All right, here we go. And the winner of the poll is cheese. So we're going to have 6 votes for cheese. Basically, all the ones that got votes, the ones that got basically the top votes are the ones that we'll take. So, cheese, dried meats, and that's it. Those are the top 2 votes. So, cheese and dried meats. Okay, which food did you take? Oh, wait, I screwed that up. Hold on. I fouled that up. Wait a second. I think I screwed that up. Hold on a second. I screwed that up. Nice, Glob. That's awesome. So, I screwed that up. I messed that up. I didn't realize that you were supposed to click on what it was you were taking. I didn't realize that. Yeah, I screwed that up. The reason I was clicking was because I messed up what I was doing. I don't want to do that. Can I have the bookmarks, please? Oh, wait a minute. These are all our bookmarks? Wait a second. So we can use all the bookmarks, guys. I didn't know that. I thought there was just one bookmark. So you can use all the bookmarks, guys. So let me ask you guys. So hold on a second. So I messed that up. We can do the storeroom again. But before I do that, do you guys want to back up to the room with the mirror or not? So I messed it up. So basically, to summarize, I didn't realize that it kept all the bookmarks. Do you want to back it up to where we went through the mirror or not? Oh my gosh. IAK, I am going to want to play Dragon Age Inquisition, but it's probably like three games down on the list, because I'm going to play this, then I'm playing Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney, then Ultima Underworld, the finishing up my Ultima Underworld run. So yes, I'm probably going to want to play it, but it might not be for like a month and a half, 2 months, man. You don't need to get it. Don't worry about getting that for me, man. You're already like crazy over generous to me, so. Hey, what's up, Johan Garo? I didn't realize that, Kill. That was totally my bad. So, definitely, it is sort of like that, Hollow, for sure. Sorry about that, guys. I messed that up. So, yeah. Decide whether or not... Yeah, so again, my fault, guys. I apologize. So, do you want to keep going with where we are right now, or do you want to back up to the room with the mirror in it? I apologize. I had no idea that it kept all of those bookmarks. I didn't realize that. So go ahead and vote if you want to keep going or go back to the room with a mirror in it. My bad. Sorry. No, Div. The reason I don't want to play Dragon Age Inquisition right now is because as of about... I checked this about 5 hours ago. There were literally 80 people. 80 people that were playing Dragon Age Inquisition. Streaming it. And I do not feel like competing with 80 other people at the moment. So, and I'm talking about, and that includes a bunch of major streamers like Carnage and people like that. So I don't want to compete with all of those guys. I am going to play Dragon Age Inquisition later, but probably like 3 or 4 games down the line as opposed to right now. So that's the idea. Yeah, I know, Gil. Well, we'll do a giveaway ourselves, but... Okay. Choose one, choose one, choose one, choose one, choose one, choose two, choose one. Yes, yeah, I was looking forward to actually doing this, Hollow, because it's been a while since I've done one of the game books, so. It has been a while. Alright. Let's see what the will of chat is. They said to keep going. IAK, what? God damn it. The other reason I don't want to play it right now is because I just... Oh, God. No, with the gift train. I have tons of games, guys. You guys have been super generous to me. Save your money for when I get partnered, hopefully. That's what we're looking at. Okay, so it looks like we're going forward for this. So let's do it. So I'm going to go to where we were, which is to go downwards. And then I'm pretty sure we said to go left. Nope, I'm wrong. I'm incorrect. Okay. There we go. All right, and I think it was left. No, I'm wrong. God bless it. All right, sorry, guys. I'm just getting us back to where we were, so just bear with me for a second. Follow them down. Right-hand stairs. Door on the right. Sorry about that. Just bear with me while I get us back to where we were, because I messed this up the last time. Right-hand stairs, door on the right. There we go. Okay. Here's where we were. My bad. So it was cheese and dried meats, I believe. Dried meats and cheese. Those are the ones we were looking for. Sorry about that. I want the cash money. No, you guys have been super generous to me already. Like, I really, really am appreciative of it very much. And IAK, you know, has been super generous to me before. I really appreciate it, man, but... you guys know I never ask for games. I'm not
you know, I've been lucky enough that I'm not poverty stricken. So, you know, I feel bad for people. I appreciate it, but it's not necessary. You guys being here and spreading the word about the stream is enough. All right, so here we go. We've taken what we liked. What food did we take? Bread and cakes restore 2 stamina points each. Dried meats, dried fish, and cheese restore 1 stamina point each. Fruit and wine will not restore any points. Wine will lose you 1 skill point, but if you drank wine, you lose 2 fear points. If you ate cheese or drank white wine, we did eat cheese. Caution should have overruled your appetite. For in the House of Droomer, cheese and white wine are not recommended, for the simple reason that anyone who eats cheese or drinks white wine will pay the penalty. They are poisoned. This is the end of your adventure. The end. Nathan Lame, you were told not to eat cheese. You were told not to drink white wine. This time you avoided drinking white wine, but you could not avoid eating cheese. The cheesy meat that Poke Dude said you should have was cheesy poison. It was Swiss death. It was Monterey jack out to the heavens. It was cheddar coffin. And in this life, Nathan Lame, when you walk into an isolated house in the middle of nowhere, run by a demon cult and a guy named the Earl of Dreamer, when someone asks you and you're in a storeroom, would you like cheese? Would you like white wine? You say, no! I love cheese, but not if it costs me my life. Cheese, life, though cheese is great, life is greater. Remember that, Nathan Lame. Remember that as you pass on into the great dairy beyond. We wish you Godspeed and a gym. That's like death number 4, I think. God, this book is so brutal. I mean, that's the reputation. It has that reputation of just being very, very brutal. It really does. All right. Whoa! There we go. Sorry about that. I forgot I have to capture this with monitor capture. My bad. All right. So, back we go. Okay. What? Oh, I have other... Fortunately, I know that I have other bookmarks. Here we go. Came back to the bagpipes. Infinity! Alright. Here we go. Alright, so here are your choices, guys. So, we can choose these two options. And I think... I want to say this is the kitchen. Let me see if this is the kitchen. Oh no, I didn't do that. Okay. So this actually is the mirror. My bad. Okay, so this backs us up now to the bookmark we were before. I thought I had booked it marked, but I thought I had bookmarked it before this. So, your choices are, if you go, you can either continue to go down the stairs, or if you go to the left, you will go to that door that looks out on the room through the mirror. So basically, and remember, there's also another door in that room behind the mirror. So your choices are, you can go down the stairs, that leads you to these other rooms that we were talking about. Or you can go through this door, and that door is going to lead you to the room with the room in the mirror, and there's a little door in this room as well. Okay? So I'm just letting you know that those are your options, and now I'm going to put up a poll about it. Okay, so going down the stairs is leading you back towards that storeroom and towards... There's some other doors down there that you didn't try as well. Or you can try to use the stair... You can use the door here, which will bring you into the room where you can either go through into the room with a mirror, or you can try another little door here also. Hi, Fallen. So those are your options. Hello, Fallen.
She was a skank. Really? Good to see you, Fallen. What's up, man? You have missed a number of deaths tonight, Fallen. There have been a number of people who have not made it. There have been a number of people who did not make it through the House of Hell. Wine makes you physically sick, yeah. There was no boss fight. No. The only boss fight that we had, we did have a battle against a zombie. You also defeated a vampire by throwing garlic at him, so he's kind of a boss. He was like a boss, if you follow what I mean. Okay, so again, if you guys are interested in making that vote, go ahead and vote either to go down the stairs or try the door in the wall. Again, the door in the wall is the one that leads to the room behind the mirror. And then through the mirror, you can either step into the room that's like a dining room type place, or you can try another little door in the room with a mirror. So those are your choices as well. All right, last call for that choice. Yes, cheese kicked your butt. The other thing you've learned is that cheese and white wine will kill you. Cheese and white wine are bad. You have learned that for certain. Lonely Island. Lonely Island is good stuff. All right. Let's see what we've got. Try door in the wall, all right. The door opens and you find yourself in a small room. There is another door leading off the room, but in front of you is a strange sight which catches your attention. A shimmering haze seems to be hanging on the wall, almost like a curtain of sparkling water. You step up to investigate and gingerly hold out your finger to touch it. Your finger passes right through. Plucking up your courage, you poke your head into the haze. On the other side, you realize what has happened. Your head has emerged through a large mirror into a reception room. On the wall opposite is a huge mural of a country scene, and standing in the middle of the room are a table and six chairs. The sound of voices outside the door startles you, and you draw your head back. Now, you have three choices, and let me remind you that going through this room eventually led us to the kitchen. I'm just letting you know, eventually we got to the kitchen when you stepped through the mirror. I'm warning you, because the kitchen, as we know, everyone remember, the kitchen is doom. So you don't want to get to the kitchen. Now, just because you go into this room doesn't mean you have to go to the kitchen, but we did go through there and ended up in the kitchen, so I'm just letting you know. We have not yet tried the other door in this little room. So your choices are step through the mirror, door in the little room, or go back. And I will put that in right now. And by either door, I mean other door, of course. The sandwiches are OP. They are. You know what's become one of my favorite sandwiches? So my two, like, favorite sandwiches lately have been... I've always loved bologna and cheese. Bologna, provolone, lettuce, and a little bit of mayo on rye bread is awesome. But the other thing that I've gotten into lately is... they call it, at the local place near me, they call it a Thor. But it's... turkey, roast turkey, Swiss cheese, Russian dressing, and coleslaw. Have you guys had that? That is awesome. On like a hero, on rye, it doesn't matter, on whatever. Turkey, Swiss cheese, coleslaw, Russian dressing on rye bread. It's really good. I'm surprised. Time to go full screen. May the force be with us. Nice. Through the mirror and beyond. Yeah, it's really good. Russian dressing, yeah. Russian dressing. Surprisingly good. It's something about the crispiness of the coleslaw mix. It's good, man. I like it. I like rye bread. But it's also good on a hero or whatever. So. Okay.